still a thriving and strong congregation in this community, still a very strong and present witness for Jesus Christ. Now, we want to welcome all of you. We have, of course, those who are coming as guests today and family members of our members here at the church, and we have former members, those that grew up in this church and have moved away. We have clergy that are here and clergy that began their ministry in this place. We have some former pastors, and we are just delighted that everyone is here. Now, we have pew registers in the pew where you're sitting, and we'd love for you to work on that project as we move along to sign in and to let us know who you are. And, of course, if you'd like to join this church, we'd welcome that. So make a note of that if you'd like to do that today. Hey. Now, I want to take just a few moments and draw your attention to the front row that's here. We have this reserved for clergy and spouses. We have Bishop Taylor's husband, Rusty, is here on the front row with us. And Jim Hyatt, who is a former pastor of this church, is here. And we're glad that they could be here with us today. We have Mike and Angela Bruce. And Mike grew up in this church and is a product of your ministry here. So, and he's been a loyal and faithful minister in this conference for the years. We appreciate him. My wife, Dora, is here. She has someone to preach for her this morning so she can be with us. We also have with us a person I've just met, David Stubbs, and his wife, Rhonda. David is from Buncombe Street, and he is the education program director there. And I looked at your website this week looked at you, and it's a beautiful website. We welcome you today. David grew up in this church. And there may be some that did not get to the front row if you're here. I know where you are. But we welcome these folks to be with us and to be a part of who we are. We've had a number of ministers that have come out of this congregation through the years. David Kenneth Townsend is a product of this church and is a retired minister. Colonel Tilden Boone, who is with the chaplaincy program at Fort Jackson, is a product of this church. Of course, I mentioned Mike Bruce and also Mike Rouse, who's one of our pastors in Dillon, is a product of this church. And of course, I mentioned David Stubbs also is a product of this church. And so we have sent some people into the ministry from this place. Also, through the years, we've had one who was an associate here, Ron Beehorn, who has done mission work in Africa. And is presently at Mount Pleasant. His daughter's getting married, so he's at Mount Pleasant getting ready for that wedding. And so he cannot be here with us today. But we are grateful for the work that God has done in this place. We also have with us today, and it's a pleasure to have Bishop Mary Virginia Taylor with us as our preacher, and you'll be meeting her in just a few moments. And Reverend Quay Adams, who is our district superintendent, is with us today and will be participating in our worship experience. Now, let me share with you that in your bulletin, there's a history of the Bennettsville Methodist Church, and you will look at that history when you get an opportunity. And also, we have a list of pastors that have served this church since the late 1800s. And the amazing thing is that we have almost every picture of these pastors. We have a few that are missing. We have those on display in our gathering room, which is right out here, and you'll be able to see those along with some other items of historical value. But you can look at the list of these pastors, and we are grateful for these who have served in this place. Also, you'll note that we have some anniversary notes in our bulletin today, and just gives you some information about our bishop and our district superintendent and some other areas that I draw your attention to this morning. We have also a church website, and you see the address to that, and we'd certainly encourage you to go in and to look at that website. Now, immediately after this worship service, we'll proceed to our Sunday dinner, and you'll just go right out this way to our Methodist Family Center, and we will be there for dinner, and we'll move directly to that occasion right after our worship here. Now, there are some announcements on the back of the bulletin. I just draw your attention to those announcements, and you can read those and to look at where various things are going on in our church. This morning we have a very special presentation. It is a skit entitled Methodist Beginnings in Marlborough County. And let me just say a little brief word about that. Betty Brown May is our playwright for this skit. She wrote this production for us. It is being directed by Virginia Hodges. The narrator is Jim Harmon. And we have characters that have been portrayed by some of our folks. Reverend Francis Asbury is being portrayed by Dr. John May. Edward Crossland is being portrayed by Cliff Crossland, who is a descendant of the Crossland, Mr. Crossland, who entertained Francis Asbury. And William J. Cook is being portrayed by Bill Kenny. And we appreciate all of those folks that have put this together. We're going to do that skit in just a moment, and then we will begin our time of worship together. But may I just say again that we are delighted to have you in our congregation today to worship here in this place. And now we have a little bit of history that we'll share with you.
Methodism came to Marlborough County over 220 years ago, when before 1783, a Methodist society was established in a simple meeting house built out of local materials on Beauty Spot lands, which was located near the upper end of present Lake Paul Wallace. It was served by itinerant circuit riding preachers. According to tradition, this was the first Methodist meeting house built in South Carolina. Over the years, the congregation built two new churches on the same site. In 1883, a new site was selected, so the fourth Beauty Spot Church was built about 3 miles north of Bennettsville on the road to Taylor. The building is no longer there, but the cemetery is maintained. Bishop Francis Asbury first visited Beauty Spot Church in February of 1788 and held a quarterly conference on the 23rd. Let's look in on his visit. Edward Crossland, a member of the Methodist Society, is speaking.
Bishop Asbury, it's a pleasure to have you in our community preaching. It's a certain honor.
Thank you, Mr. Crossland. It's a very distinct pleasure to accept the hospitality of your home while I'm visiting in Beauty Spot. And I'm looking forward to the meetings with your society.
We have called for a meeting on the 23rd, this coming Saturday, the 23rd, and we were expecting a very large gathering.
I keep a daily journal to record my activities. This is what I wrote on this visit to Petersburg. Thursday, February the 21st, 1788. Very comfortable at home. Saturday, the 23rd, I attended the quarterly meeting in Peter's spot. The weather was cold, but I had great assistance with Isaiah 26, 1 through 6. On Sunday, I preached on Zechariah, the 11th chapter, the 11th verse. We had a gracious, moving time. On Monday, I crossed the PD River at Long's Bluff and rode nearly 50 miles to Dawson. That was a very exhausting trip.
The town of Bennettsville was established when the courthouse was moved to a central location in 1819. The Methodists had established a society here before 1834. They worshiped at the Beauty Spot Church north of town. But as the population grew and it appeared that Bennettsville would someday grow to be a town of some size and importance, a movement was started to build a church in town. Let's meet William J. Cook.
I've lived in Bennettsville for several years, and I worship at Beauty Spot Church. Since our town is growing, and it is difficult to go 2 to 3 miles to worship, some of our society members have said, we ought to have our own church. I have a lot of land. It's 1.5 acres in size on the north side of East Darlington Street. And I've offered this to the trustees as a site for our new church. They have accepted, and they tell me construction will begin this year, 1834. I bid you good day.
The church was a simple wooden square building without a steeple nor other adornment. It had a quadrangular roof ending in a sharp point at the apex. The two front doors opened directly on the street. A bell hung on a platform outside the church. This building served the congregation until 1871, when a new church was built on this same lot. It was larger, and the interior had a semicircular chancel with the inscription on the wall behind the pulpit, "Thou God seest me." In June 1899, a church conference was initiated, and plans for a large brick building were made on the same site. It was completed in 1903, and the exterior walls comprised the present church. A church school addition was built in 1925. The extensive renovation of the sanctuary was done in 1955-56, and the Methodist Family Center was added in 1975. The entire church plant was renovated in 2005-2006 to give us the building we are enjoying this morning. And remember, our church is where the congregation first worshiped 175 years ago.
about the tragic and devastating fires that have been raging since the middle of this week in Horry County, north and east of Conway, and along the area in Myrtle Beach and North Myrtle Beach. There are tens of thousands of acres that have been charred. The timberlands are still smoking. And we all know they will reemerge one day with the goodness of God. But there are also charred rubbles. All that's left are some 200 homes where only concrete slabs or metal frames remain from the fires of homes and manufactured homes. Hopefully the winds will abate and the now 85% control fire will soon be over. How can we help? Pray. Pray. Pray for all those who have sustained loss during these days. United Methodists in this corner of South Carolina can well remember the tornadoes that have leveled a section of Bennettsville in 1984 and in Clio just 3 or 4 years ago. Let us be as compassionate and as generous as persons were when these events occurred in this part of our state. The biggest needs presently are toiletries and beddings and summer or spring clothing. Please separate men's and women's and children's and youth clothing so that the centers there will not have to go through that. There is a drop-off point in Long, South Carolina, and at the Chamber of Commerce on Oak Street in Myrtle Beach. Thank you for your response to this. And secondly, let me just say a brief word about this celebration today. First United Methodist Church has been richly blessed over the past 175 years, and it is an honor for Mildred and me, Bishop Mary Virginia Taylor, other pastors and who have come out of this church, and perhaps those who have served here, and also those of you who are laity who have come together here to celebrate his glorious past. It has been said that the great Duke of Wellington revisited the school where he studied as a boy on one occasion, and as he looked upon that scene, his eyes were filled with tears, and he said, it was here that Waterloo was won. If this morning we could say that it was here that the great questions of life were solved, what a marvelous company this would be. Seneca, in one of his essays, makes his pilot say, "O Neptune, you may sink me or you may save me, but I will keep my rudder true." I implore First United Methodist Church to remember its history and to remember who and whose you are, so that even though the marble and brass and wood of the edifice changes, and you all have done a wonderful job of transforming the past into the present, that none of this ever touches the human love that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. You have received a goodly and a godly blessing and heritage. I implore you to lift high the cross, the love of Christ proclaimed, for the world adores his sacred name. Thank you very much. And now will you join me as we share the call of worship. Within these hallowed walls, generations of Christians have worshipped.
We praise God of the ages.
Within these hallowed walls, our pastors have preached God's truth.
We honor those who have proclaimed God's grace.
Within these hallowed walls, we have observed the sacraments of our faith.
We celebrate the grace that has been bestowed upon us.
Within these hallowed walls, we come from many places and stationed in life to remember the heritage of our faith, and to move victoriously into a new day.
We celebrate this day and open our hearts to a new day of worship and ministry.
Let us now together praise Almighty God. God is, there is the one true church, whose holy faith let us now declare together.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Oh, Father, we thank you for hearing our prayers. We thank you that as we have shared our concerns with you, that we can discover that you are already concerned about our needs and who we are and what we have need of in our lives. We thank you for hearing us as we have shared with you thanksgiving and adoration to you For truly we come this morning to adore you and to praise your holy name and to thank you for blessing us over and over. Father, as we have received blessings from you, help us to be mindful of those who need to be blessed in their lives and use us to provide blessing, that we may share with those who are hurting, that we may share a time of comfort for them, that we may share in however you choose to lead us to do that ministry. Father, we especially want to remember those along the coast and up around North Myrtle Beach and in the Conway area who have suffered tremendously these past days. We pray for them. We pray that out of this incident that you will move in a very special way and that people will be drawn to you as they see the love that is shown to those that are hurting, as they see that you want to work in their lives. Father, lead us in those things that we can do to provide for them as we pray and as also we give and share what we have with those that are in such need. Father, we pray also today for those that are having difficulty with sickness, who are struggling and suffering. We pray for healing and for a healing touch. And Father, we've heard in many different ways. So I pray this morning for people who are hurting spiritually that they might be redeemed in their lives and set free. I pray for those who are struggling with emotional situations that they may have a healing in their emotions. Those that hurt physically, I pray for them today. They may have that healing in their bodies. And for those that have difficulty financially today, we pray that you may open up the doors that need to be opened, that you may send help and relief to those that are hurting in that way. Father, we are your people. We have come together in this place as members of this church and as farmer members and family members and guests and people who have just come to be a part of this experience. Father, we belong to you as we have accepted Jesus Christ into our lives, that we have accepted that redemption. So, Father, we thank you that you have called us not only to salvation, but also to ministry, that we may minister in your name that wherever we may be. And I pray for this church, that as we celebrate our past, that we also are encouraged for the future. That we are here in this place, that we are ministry in this area. And we know that as we follow you, you will lead us. Help us to be open to you. Help us to know that you have called us to discipleship. That you have called us just as you called those men in those early days, those men and women that you called to your ministry, that you also call us. And so now we join together in the prayer that Jesus has taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. At this time, we want to present the tithes and our offerings to the Lord, if the ushers would.